And then in relation to the map, are you able to locate that particular street?
Well, it's not on map number 4.
Okay, let's proceed. Whilst we are on this time, I want us to quickly refer now to the GPRS stream around this time.
When you say around this time, are you saying it's 2032?
That's correct, my lord.
Okay. Do you want me to have a look at the data on the GPS?
Yes.
Okay. 26th October. So we are looking at...
Which page are you?
We are looking at page 114. That's the first page of GPRS data for the 26th, towards the middle of the page. And we're looking for time,
32.
So on this one, 26th October 2014, the last entry for the GPRS data is 1852.
Yes.
That was internet usage, and Alexander Park was picked up as the tower.
And the PDP address?
PDP 41.29.53.180.
And the volume in bytes?
440.
And let's go back to the AMA data.
Yes.
Any other activities on the 26th of October beyond 2032?
No, that was the last activity.
Are you able to tell this court if the phone or the handset at that time beyond 2032 and 57 stayed on the Vodacom network or not?
No. It looks like for a period for about 8 hours, there were no activities. The next activity was only on the 27th of October, round about 8:08:17.
And then during that time, was the phone ever switched off?
There's no activity reflecting, so it could be off, or it could have just not been in use during that time.
So let me get this right. If the subscriber does not make a call, or he does not receive a call during that time, it will not show anything.
That's correct.
And then we go back now to the GPRS data as well. If the user or the subscriber does not go to the internet, it will not show any activities.
Correct.
I want us now then to zoom into the last activity, which is the SMS. And let's try to be precise. From the SMS to the first activity on the EMA data the following day, let's count how many hours to be precise.
12 hours difference.
It's on the EMA data.
Yes.
And then on the GPRS data?
So it's more or less the same, 12 hours.
Request the states to work with us to specifically refer the page at which he's quoting those MIR data and the GPRS. Otherwise, we're missing him, or he's missing us.
Okay. On the MIR data, we're on page 11 of 184. And the GPRS data, we are on page 114 of 184.
Correct.
The tower location of the last activity on the 26th of October 2014, you said it was Holt Street, SGS2.
Correct.
And then on the GPRS data, the tower?
The tower was Alexander Park, SGS3.
The time?
18:52, 30 seconds.
Now let's move to the next date. On the AMA data. The first activity recorded?
On the next date, on the
page 11.
under AMA data is the 27th of October 2014 at 080817. The number ending 8169 received a call from the number ending 0728, which lasted 66 seconds, and the tower that was picked up there was Moy Street.
Okay, I want to refer you now to Exhibit S, Annexure C, on page 11.
Index number 16, name.
Okay, let's confirm the number before we get to the name. Is it the correct same number that there was a transaction with?
That is correct, yes.
Sorry. Read it into the record, the number.
082.
The number was 082.
255.
255.
207.
07.
28.
280.
Storage and sim. And the name is Ugezekile.
Okay. Now let's proceed to page 114, the GPRS stream. The first activity recorded on the 27th of October 2014.
The first activity is on the 27th at 06:52, 30 seconds. The tower that was picked up there was Moy Street.
And the volume in bytes?
6116571.
And this volume in bytes is in kilobytes, correct?
It starts off with the smallest, yes.
Are you able to quantify it into megabytes?
Not at this stage, no.
We'll get back to that. Let's go back to the AMA data. And then the second activity on the 27th of October 2014?
That was at 08:23, 59 seconds. The number ending 8169 received a call from the number ending 5095, and Moy Street was still picked up.
Can you just from 18:55 to 17:34 on the 27th of October, can you just take us through the towers that it was pinging?
Okay, that would be on the next page.
Correct.
18:55. I actually have from 18:32:19. Which is,
yes,
towards the middle of the page.
That's correct. Yeah. Which towers can you just tell the court?
From that time, Belgravia was picked up.
Jokes, sorry, it's 18:32 and 19 seconds. It's okay, Belgravia.
Until 19:57, 20 seconds.
We have here 19:57 and Mishumama Bini.
Now, let's concentrate on the call recorded at 18:32 and 19.
That was an incoming call to the number ending 8169 from the number ending 3517, which lasted 42 seconds.
So, lapha ke kwakuyikhona evela kule number egcina ngo 8169 engena kule number i-8169 ivela kune number i-3517 wagcina behleli imizuzwana eyamashumi amane nambili.
And then as per exhibit S, annexure C, the number ending with 3517, how was it identified? Index number 197.
Index 197, the number 071507 3517, name Nkani, storage Yusum.
So lapha ngaphansi kwa index 197 inamba ke elapho 071507 3518 igama Unkani.
Interpreter,
I think he's wrong.
197. index 197.
Right, and the number is?
071-507-3517.
Right. Yeah. Now, the interpreter made a mistake. No, did you say 8, and ending 8?
No, it is 3517, my lord.
Yeah, it doesn't end with 8. Fine, no problem.
I must apologize if I said 8, my lord.
Yeah, you said it.
I was saying 7.
Ask Mr. Mnisi.
Yes, and then the tower location?
The tower picked up was Belgravia.
Do you know where this tower is?
No idea.
Just tell me from my understanding, Vodacom, they are the persons who installed the towers, is that not so?
Yes.
You must have a directory of towers.
That's correct, yes.
Okay, fine. At least I know now that each and every tower must have a map, must have an information, like you're saying, a directory.
Yes. But, yeah. We have over 10,000 plus towers.
That's it, yeah. Okay, fine.
Okay. On page 114, on the GPRS stream, any other activity on the 27th of October 2014?
Yes, there were activities from 6:42 the morning of 27th.
No, that one you already testified about, the second one of the date.
The date at 8:13?
Yes.
Yes, there was activity at 8:13:13. Moy Street was picked up. That was picked up right until 8:56, 14 seconds, 28th of October.
28th of October.
2014.
2014.
Let's take this step by step, entry by entry.
Okay.
From 18:13, which one is the next transaction?
12:01:32 on the 27th of October, 2014. Moy Street was picked up at the same time, 12:01:32 seconds, Moy Street. We can then move on to the next date, the 28th of October, 2014, at 00:01.
We'll visit that after lunch. Let's clarify this, the 27th of October, 2014.
Sure.
The duration of the session, the internet session.
Please repeat yourself.
I'm saying the duration.
Yes.
Yes.
The duration on 12:01:32, the first entrance is 92, and the second duration is 43:108.
Okay. It's going backwards now. 6:52.
On which date?
27 October 2014.
27. At 6:52, 30 seconds. The duration was 4843. And the tower picked up was Moy Street.
Okay, and then lastly on this.
We are lost again. The challenge is the state simply mentions the time and but does not take us directly to the page at which he is. Now, I'm struggling to get to that 852 on the information that I have here.
Did indicate, my lord, is 114. GPRS stream page 114.
Yeah, at least if the states indicate that we are now on GPRS and we are now on the towers and everything, or on the AMA.
But I do indicate, my lord, that now we are moving to the GPRS stream.
You just call the date and the time. You don't indicate whether we are on GPRS or AMA.
My lord, can we then adjourn for lunch? It is 1 o'clock.
What's your time?
It's 1 o'clock.
Oh, is that so?
Okay. So if you've made it this far in the video, please make sure you drop a like. Now let's get into the breakdown. What is really going on with the state? To be honest, we are still talking phone numbers. What accused number 3 was doing with his phone. Now imagine that this is for a murder. trial, okay? This is for a murder trial, but the focus is on his cell phone and pinging his location after the point of murder. If you missed part one and two, I'm going to link it up here so you can follow through if you're really into the numbers. But basically, this is seriously a waste of time. After doing these three videos, I still do not know what happened to Senzo Meyiwa. I mean, this is devastating for me. I can only imagine what this is like for the family. This is a waste of resources, a waste of time. What is going on with Sibanda and how Baloyi and Judge Rata are simply not interrupting him with this gameplay he's doing? I think that he should have conceded by now and let the defense start cross-examining her, because why do we need to know all these towers? Where is this going? You know, in the beginning, I started to follow. I said, okay, let me follow the numbers. Let me follow the bouncing ball. Let me see where he's going. But all he is doing is scoring and scoring goals for the defense team. Now he's introduced a new name. So when he introduces a name, he never explains who it is. Now he's introduced a new name, Ukezepi. Who is that? And why should we care that he called accused number three? Did he have any part in the murder of Senzo Meyiwa? Did he have any part in supplying the weapon that murdered Senzo Meyiwa? Do you see that we are going down a slippery slope? We are going down a rabbit hole. We are just going down and we have no idea where we're going. We literally have no idea where we're going. When we know there are seven people who were in the house who can tell us a better story of what happened to Senzo Meyiwa on the 26th of October, 2014. That's the only date that matters. So I'm not going to do video number four, because after this, he starts to go into 2018 and 2019. Why should we care? Why should we care? I mean, this is absolutely crazy to me. I am just so shocked that this continued for an entire day in court. Today, court sits later on because accused number three is not going to be in court. He's not going to make it to court for 10 a.m. because he has to go to the doctor. He has to go to the doctor to get his fracture checked. And, you know, this is his day out as well. So the court has to wait for him to be done. Do you think that court will sit today, or this will be another delay as we await justice for Senzo Meyiwa? That is it from me today, Mzansi. Please remember to drop a like for this video. It is absolutely free. It costs you absolutely nothing. If you want to join our membership program so you can use our exclusive emojis, be sure to join. To hit the join button, I'm going to link it at the end of the screen. It's going to say Unapologetic Podcast. Click on that. It will take you to the join button. Or in the description box, you will find a link to our join section. I promise not to rob you. It will always be affordable. So Mzansi, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And we cannot wait to get back into the courthouse. And hopefully Pinky is now going to be led in the direction of who killed Senzo Meyiwa. Drop a soccer emoji down in the comment section down below. If you are here for the justice for Senzo Meyiwa, if you're trying to figure out who killed Senzo Meyiwa, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you where on my next upload. And if you have made it this far in the video, you already know you're part of my VIP gang, gang, gang. You too, drop a heart emoji in the comment section, because if you do not drop an emoji, I do not know that you actually watched the video. Thanks so much for watching.